Parliament sittings will resume tomorrow after 2 weeks of a partial recess that was announced by the Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayebwa on 31st of October following a stalemate in the House caused by the opposition boycott of House sittings. As the plenary resumes tomorrow, the Leader of Opposition says nothing has changed to convince them to return to the House.
Our stance then and now is that we are out of plenary sittings until we have received that response. And there's no new development since then.
Mpuga noted that the number of meetings they have held with government agencies to discuss the issues at hand have not borne fruits to convince them to end the boycott.
The meeting was implied by the Right Honourable Speaker that we'll have a follow-up meeting on Wednesday. Since she's the same person who has outed the order paper, the meeting is again upon her to either reschedule or advise otherwise. Otherwise, from our standpoint of view, we are still stuck to where we are. But make no mistake, we never fear to engage anyone that wants to engage with us.
Addressing the media at Parliament today, he noted that there is also an item to do with human rights which has been placed on the order paper this week, and they will not lure them to return to the House until they digest the contents in the government statement.
I expect government to communicate to me officially so that together with the caucus, we process the contents of the response to be able to verify their efficacy and detail.
On the issue of our missing brothers, as alleged by opposition, I think as the government need to come out with facts, comprehensive facts, a statement which has facts, because as I was reading, they are saying it's opposition is lying.
However, some opposition legislators are fed up with the perpetual boycott and want their leaders to change tactics. Dennis Onekaleta Mere, the MP for Kitgum Municipality of FDC, says time has come for opposition to return to the House and fight from within.
I feel the boycotts we have exhibited is now enough. Another strategy should be fighting from within. There is no way we, the opposition, would boycott and then NRM divide themselves to sit on our side, as if nothing has happened.
The NRM legislators have also extended an olive branch to their opposition counterparts, urging them to return to the House and fight from inside. They have pledged to join them to amplify their grievances.
When they still boycott to come back in the Parliament, I see that being unfair to the people who voted them. Because Speaker Nalonga Anita Among held a meeting with the opposition leaders and the ministers concerned, because their major purpose that there are some people who are not still available, moreover, they submitted to government to avail them.
Well, it's a message from them, but to me, I think the best alternative in solving anything is to sit and talk. So if you keep away, then where do you present the issues?
The opposition has summarized their grievances in the 6 points, including the demand for the 18 missing persons, targeting and victimizing Muslims, detention without trial, violation of human rights in the fishing communities, shrinking civic space, and trying of civilians in the court-martial. The opposition caucus is scheduled to meet on Wednesday to make a final decision. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.